class. I hope you are understanding whatever we are doing here. In case you have any problem, you know, what's the platform for clearing your doubts? The live class. Every time in the live class, you will be writing your doubts and asking me. And I'll try my best to solve your problems. Whatever you are not understanding, keep noting down. Keep noting down in a notebook and we'll talk about those problems in the live class. Now, coming to page 12, we left going page 12. Coming back to page 12 of lesson 1. These are called one word substitution. For a long part of a sentence, we can use simply one word. Instead of using 5, 6, 7 words or 4, 5 words, we can manage using one word. Like somebody who loves his country, his or her country a lot is called a patriot. Someone who loves his or her country a lot, is ready to do anything for the country, is called a patriot. A big stretch of sand, you know, you have been doing in SS, it's called a desert. My brother's son or my sister's son will be called my nephew. Will be called my nephew. My brother's or my sister's daughter will be called my niece. My brother's or sister's daughter, for females we use the word niece and for sons we use the word nephew. My mother's mother or my father's mother is called my granny or grandmother. Here, exercise, I'm sending you in the worksheet. This is only to understand. This is what we call one word substitution. Instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words, I'll use one word. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words, I'll use one word. So this is one word. I'm replacing. Substitute means replace. Fine. Next exercise, very very easy and interesting, I love it. Page 13, what is it? What's drawn here? Car plus PET, pet, carpets. Yes, carpets. We have drawn sun and use the word, written is light. It will be sunlight. We have hand and some. Oh, handsome. All my boys in the class are handsome. We have a cup here and board cupboard. We keep our clothes in the cupboard. We keep our things in the cupboard. Fine. And in next one is a must take them exercise. You all know this story? I'm sure you all know this story. Lovely. So this is a story about a crow getting feeling very thirsty. He goes around, gets the pebbles, brings it. There was very little water in the pot. He puts the pebbles in the pot, the water level rises up, the crow drinks the water, feels happy and flies away. But what happened here? The sentences are not given in a sequence. They are given haphazardly, itarka. And put together. So that will not make a proper story. What you have to do is make it into a proper story. First do it yourself, then check the worksheet. First do it yourself, number the sentences in a proper sequence, then check the answer in the worksheet. You will love doing it. Now the next and the last exercise of this lesson is just 5 things that happen every day. Only 5 things you need to mention that happen every day. So first is, what do we do the first thing we get up in the morning? The moment we get up, my mommy tells me, go and brush your teeth. So you can say, I brush my teeth every day. Then, having bath, sometimes windows may you don't have, right? So don't write that. I'll send you 5 sentences in the worksheet. First you do. First you try doing it. Then you tally with the worksheet, okay? Under assignment section. You are getting 5 sentences. Fine. So it is over. I hope you enjoyed doing the chapter. And next time we meet, it will be your fun with grammar term. Get your fun with grammar book ready. We'll have it with lesson 2. Okay.